essentially don't want to argue with us, but they know that it's just a matter of wills before, or a matter of time before their will overtakes ours, before we get frustrated, before we give up, before we say, all right, just do whatever you want to do. And that's what they're waiting for. But with
chair. That's when I just go
lock
her up.
So like Billy was saying, all we're looking for is just that level of attention. Just what level she's feeling, and just teaching her.
Going through the door is a huge thing for her, because every dog sees doorways as a channel, and when dogs see a channel, so let's say even just a tunnel, like a agility tunnel, if you see even a slug of a dog coming very slow, once they get in that tunnel, they speed up because they have to hurry up to get to the other side. Something really exciting on the other side. That's why our dogs really don't like to wait at the door, because they see it, there's something more exciting outside. So any channel, whether that's a hallway, a doorway, a tunnel, a set of steps, or a gate even, it's very hard for our dogs to have control right there. So because we don't want to run away from the problems, he's doing this because this is going to help her to focus more on Nate, because he's giving her permission to come and go. He's in control of her right now, and if he's in control, she has to trust him. If she has to trust him, then we're already 10 steps ahead of the curve, right? And that's where we always want to be, especially when you have a dog that's unpredictable. You need to be ahead of that dog. The structure is provided, right? If she follows him, she has to trust him. If she didn't trust him, that would have been like a 45-minute ordeal out there. Nate would have knocked out his franchise certificate and just sent him home.
That was quick, too.
And it's just attention, right? It's all about attention. It's not about confrontation whatsoever. Just want to be able to build that trust and that followership from our dog. But that doorway, you know, that's even, it just gets them off balance, because they're so used to just busting through. You know, they have to hurry up and get to the other side no matter what. They always have to hurry. So putting them in that situation, like you asked yesterday, what would you do? You know, what would you do if you had issues like this at someone's house and they didn't have an elevated place or something like that? Use a doorway. Use some kind of channel, because you're in control of that. You start them, you stop them, you start them, you stop them. You're in control. They have to fall in line really.